So this one's Dead Island. I've used the same editor, which I will put in the description and try and find out, because it's been a long time since I downloaded it, who made it. I'll put that in the description too. Deserves a lot of credit. You can mess with inventory and skills. You can mess with map, but I've never done that. You can fill up all the skills, but and the same with inventory space or how much ammo you can carry, it will mess with your perks and your skills. And it will look all strange when you come in here and you won't be able to select perks. So this is Purna. They'll start at level 1. Purna is mostly loaded with guns because she is the gun expert. Sam B will have blunt weapons mostly. Xiang will have mostly sharp weapons, and most of the mods are all ones you normally can't put on such weapon. So like that's a Phoenix mod on a knife. It says flames coming out of it. It's got the effects, but it doesn't have all the glowing effects and stuff. Explosive mod, which is actually a sticky bomb mod, kills everything in one hit, burns them to death, but be careful running over it. Home Run is also a developer mod, which is just overpowered, and so is Mind Blowing. We'll show you these ones now. This is the Home Run mod. Yeah, Mind Blowing. Yes, that's on my fists. It doesn't work when you use it like that though. And that's the explosive mod on an auto rifle with unlimited ammo. Most of the guns I put unlimited ammo, some of them I didn't. Like the Defender of the Motherland, I like to keep one of them that doesn't have too much ammo, just normal. Oh, come on now, come on. Now, Dead Island won't let you copy your save games across from the PlayStation. I've used Fallout New Vegas, that works. I've also used, what do you call it, Gran Turismo, that works. The tutorial I watched years ago that showed me how used Black Ops, or Black Ops 2, to. So most saves off your PlayStation should be able to use as a profile in brute force. As you know, once you've got the profile, you can save, convert your saves to that ID to your machine. So I'll give you a quick look at Sam B. He's got a heap of blunt weapons. Actually, no, I won't. We might go to the Oh yeah, you can use the save editor too to collect all the collectibles without collecting them. But where's the fun in that? So I think it looks like, yeah, I've still only got a few weapons unlocked. When you go to gin to your storage, you'll notice is stuff it. That's what I'm gonna do. Okay, I'll be right back. So, I've gone to my storage in the arena. It just takes too long to go and unlock gin. I've wasted enough time today. I don't have another half hour. So, yeah, these are some of the ones that I made. There's also, yeah, abundance. I've really stacked stuff. If you look at the medikits, a stack of 5,000. But yeah, there's a heap of weapons here you normally should not be able to make without the save editor. Let's have a look. Oh yeah. can't see it, but that thing explodes really good. So I made up all 10 slots. There's pretty much duplicates on 1, 2, 3, 4, and 6, 7, 8, 9. 5 is Rider White, and 10 is a fully modded Sam B with his all the perks and everything. Full inventory, extra ammo, he's loaded. You can use... I've already told you that. I think that's about it. I'll show you some other characters anyway. This thing will pop up every time you... Oh, it didn't, because I've already started playing this one just before. Oh, damn. That's right, I'm still on Purna. Funny how that works. Autosave, gotta love it. Back to where I was at my last save. Damn, nearly killed myself. But anyway, Sam B's loaded with blunts. His yarn's loaded with sharps. Purna's loaded with guns. They will all start with a corrupted message. Just click OK and continue on like normal. I think it's something to do with the save editor. It never used to do that. It's only been since I come in to test the games in the last day or so. It never used to do that. I guess at some stage it was updated again. Yeah. There's also oh no, that's right. No, that was mod menus I had on my jailbreak, which I no longer have. That's about it. You can try out the other characters for yourself. We'll just do a quick resign, because it will use multiple saves. You don't have to use Dead Island because you can't copy Dead Island. So you can just use, I used Fallout New Vegas, I've used Gran Turismo, and Black Ops can be used. Every time I tried to download a save game for Dead Island, it was always save slot 2, which is actually number 1. And it would always overwrite my character on that slot. So I'm going to do a tutorial showing how to change slot numbers for the games that will allow multiple save games. It won't work on games like Test Drive or whatever, where there's only one save. That should be about all. There's nothing else to cover, I don't think. I'll show you something quickly. This is the Dead Island save editor that I'm going to put in the description. So you just go, you know what? Oh yeah, I've got my USB in there. That just pops up every time. Click OK. And this is the save games on my stick. So this is the Purna one we're just looking at. This is the fully modded Zambi. So if you look at this, skills are absolutely maxed. 16 of 13 for 16 of 13, 10 of 3. So it's got a whole bunch of... It only doesn't have that one because I think that's the attract attention, maybe? Oh no, that's right, yeah, because it kills people by doing you damage, I think was the one. I'm not 100% sure, don't quote me on that. I haven't played the game in a long time. So yeah, this Sam B has all the collectibles. And this is what the inventory looks like. If you want to add a weapon, so let's say we'll add a, we'll just add a weapon, stick, alright, let's add a bush mask, and we'll put it in storage, it'll be here, now you can change the condition, make sure you click this twice, for some reason it doesn't always do it the first time, You can put a mod on here. So what was it? Machete. We will add I'm not sure. I can't put developer mods. I can, but they don't always work. So the hot rod mod will most likely change the appearance. So what we can do is add the Phoenix mod, say that's made for axes, and it has a flame effect. It will still give you the effects of the Phoenix and a flames coming out of the machete, but it won't. And we can change the required level there. You can change it to 60 if you want a maxed out weapon, or we'll just keep it at 1 so you can use it right from the start. With the guns, this is where you do the ammo. You can just put 999. I do it about 7 times. Yeah, and that's your rarity. And I don't click... Unbreakable seems to mess with a lot of time. You can do full upgrade there. And that's about it. Or if you want, you can drag it over here into your... There you go. That's about it. And then you just go save. So there'll be 10 saves on there. Again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9 are all pretty much duplicates of each other, so you don't have to overwrite saves you already have. 5 is Rider White, and 10 is a maxed out Sam B with this. That's the one we're looking at right now with all the skills. And no doubt if I look at his... Okay, maybe not. For some reason he still has a standard ammo. Oh, I don't know. Maybe in game it's different. That's all. That is all. I'll put this in the description with the save games. And start on a tutorial on how to control the save slots. I'm pretty sure what's next. And change ID and region. I just don't have doubles of games anymore in different regions, that's all. If I had my jailbreak, it would make it a lot easier, but I could still show you how to do it. So, okay, that's it. Have fun. Oh, and if you have problems re-signing, just go to the tutorial. I'll put the link in there as well. Good luck.